गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इन इकोनॉमिक्स वी हैव कंप्लीटेड चैप्टर नंबर 3। चैप्टर 3 देन 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th, then 9th. Means total 6 chapter we have completed out of 11. Now chapter number means which are left. Chapter number 1st, 2nd, 8th, then 10th and 11th. 5 chapters are left, in which we are going to start today chapter number 1, a very short chapter. Chapter number 1, an introduction. Economics and introduction. So total out of 11, once again we have already completed 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9, means 6 chapter we have completed, 5 chapters are left, and today we are going to complete this chapter also, chapter number 1. Name of chapter is economics and introduction. Now on page number 1st, page number 1, meaning of economics, page number 1, try to underline those sentences which may come in the form of one mark question or MCQ. In this chapter there is nothing to explain, only for one mark question or general questions will come. Meaning of economics, page number 1, the word economics in Indian thought is Arthashastra, means the Hindi version of economics or Hindi meaning of economics is Arthashastra, which is derived from the Sanskrit word Arth. The first, Arthashastra, Shastra derived from Sanskrit word Arth, which means meaning, purpose or goal. The meaning of Arth is purpose or goal. So Arthashastra, this is the Hindi meaning of economics, and this word is derived from Sanskrit word Arth. Arth means purpose or goal. Second one is important, second para. The English word economics is derived from, the English word economics, this is English word economics, but it is derived from Greek word, this is only for MCQ, Greek word oikonomics, oikonomos. This Greek word from which economics word, which is English word, is derived. And meaning of economics means it has two parts, oiko and nomos. Oiko means household, household, and nomos means that is given management. Nomos means management, means household plus management. Means in one line, economics means management of household. Management of household. The meaning of economics means management of household.
Now page number 2 means you are not required to do anything from page number 2, only for MCQ question. Page number 2. Various economists, means we are talking about Western economist, means European economist, they had given different definition time to time regarding economics, but we have to learn only one or two sentences regarding MCQ question. For example, page number 2, heading is, top point is 1.3, heading is development of economics as a science in the West. In that, you can see fourth para. This is about first page number 1. Write down page number 1 if you are making notes. Only two or three sentence. Arthashastra, that is Sanskrit word for economics. This is a Hindi meaning and it is derived from Sanskrit word. Arth, which means purpose or goal. Then English word economics is derived from Greek word oikonomos and oikonomos, which has two different words. Oiko means household, nomos means management of household is called economics. This is page number 1. Now page number 2. On page number 2, name of different economist has been given and which type of book on economics they had published and in which year, that is means for MCQ or one mark question. Here I am writing page number 2 and different economist names are given. For example, first one is Adam Smith. And heading is development of economics as a science in the West. In that, 1, 2, 3, fourth para. In fourth para, there is important question that means for MCQ. Adam Smith wrote in 1776. In the year 17, in short, I am writing only year. I am writing 1776. He had written a book named An Inquiry into the Nature and Causes of Wealth of Nation. Later on, this book is popularly known as Wealth of Nation. So we can write Wealth of Nation. Wealth of Nation. So what is the name of book which was written by Adam Smith? Wealth of Nation. In which year it was published? In the year 1776. Next one is Alfred Marshall. And beside this, means only you have to learn year or if book they had published. Beside this, you are not required to do anything on page number 2. Only name of economist, Alfred Marshall. Definition of economics by Alfred Marshall. In his book Principle of Economics, published in the year 1890. So he had published the book in the year 1890 and name of the book was Principle of Economics. Principle of Economics. Then third one is Definition of Economics by Lionel Robbins. Lionel Robbins. In case of Lionel Robbins, second para, hence in 1931, Lionel Robbins in his book, means he had published his book in the year 1931. Now what is the name of book? Nature and Significance of Economics. Nature and Significance of Economics.
Now page number 3, definition of economics by Paul Samuelson, fourth economist, Western economist, Paul Samuelson. In his book Foundation of Economics Analysis, published in 1947, so his book was published in the year 1947, and name of the book was Foundation of Economics. These points you have to learn for MCQ question. MCQ or one word means who has given the concept of wealth of nation. We can say question may be come in this way: who has given the concept of wealth of nation? So Adam Smith. In which year he has published the book? 1776. Or question may be come in other way, that Adam Smith had published the book in which year and what is the name of that book? So Wealth of Nation, the name of the book was Wealth of Nation, and in the year 1776 it was published. 1776, okay. Then Alfred Marshall has published his book in which year and what was the name of that book? The name of the book was Principle of Economics, and he had published the books in the year 1890. In this way, one mark question or MCQ question may come. So page number 2 is completed. Now page number 3, which is a Lenny photo. On page number 1, only 2 questions are there. One, the Sanskrit meaning of economics, and Greek, from which language or from which word economics word is derived? Greek word oikonomos. And what is the meaning of oikonomos? Oikonomos has 2 words, oiko and nomos. Oiko means household, and nomos means management of household. The process of management of household is called economics. Now page number 3. Beside these 4 points, you are not required to do anything from page number 2. Now page number 3. Page number 3, topic is economic activity and non-economic activity. Economic activity and non-economic activity. Now this topic is important for 1 or 2 marks, but I think this topic, economic activity and non-economic activity, we have already done in OC subject chapter number 1, but then also I am explaining, but I think I had already done completed this economic activity and non-economic activity in OC chapter number 1. Economic activities, first of all, economic activities are those activities which can be undertaken in order to earn money. In order to earn money, or in order to earn income, or in other way we can explain that economic activities are those activities which can be measured in terms of money. First point, economic activities can be measured. Or still you have any doubt regarding question, which type of question will come, you can ask at the end of the lecture. Page number 1, you have to learn only 2 sentences, Sanskrit meaning or Greek version. Second, page number 2, only name of the economist, year in which they had published the book on the basis of economics, and name of their books. Now page number 3, topic is economic activity and non-economic activity, which we have already done in OC chapter number 1. Then also I am repeating, economic activities are those activities which can be undertaken in order to earn money or in order to carry their livelihood. लाइवलीहुड, कोई भी परिवार जो अपना घर चलाने के लिए कोई एक्टिविटी करते हैं जिसमें आवक होती है, सच टाइप ऑफ एक्टिविटीज आर कॉल्ड इकोनॉमिक एक्टिविटीज. तो इट कैन बी मीन्स इकोनॉमिक एक्टिविटी कैन बी मेजर्ड इन टर्म्स ऑफ मनी. थर्ड पॉइंट, इकोनॉमिक एक्टिविटीज आर क्लासिफाइड इंटू थ्री कैटेगरीज वी हैव ऑलरेडी डन इन ओसी. थ्री कैटेगरीज आर ए बिजनेस, सेकेंड वन इज बी बिजनेस इंडस्ट्री एंड थर्ड वन इज सी आई थिंक कॉमर्स. कॉमर्स इंक्लूड्स टू थिंग्स, टू पॉइंट्स, ट्रेड एंड ऑक्सिलरीज टू ट्रेड, बिजनेस इंडस्ट्री एंड कॉमर्स. दीज आर थ्री डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ कैटेगरीज. सेम पॉइंट्स यू हैव टू लर्न विच यू हैव ऑलरेडी डन इन ओसी. नाउ इकोनॉमिक नॉन इकोनॉमिक एक्टिविटीज, अपोजिट ऑफ दैट, नॉन इकोनॉमिक एक्टिविटीज आर दोज एक्टिविटीज विच कैन नॉट बी और विच आर अंडरटेकन आउट ऑफ लव एफेक्शन, टुवर्ड्स फैमिली, टुवर्ड्स सोसाइटी. वॉट एवर एक्टिविटीज वी आर डूइंग, सच एक्टिविटीज आर कंसिडर्ड एज नॉन इकोनॉमिक एक्टिविटीज. एंड सेकेंड पॉइंट, नॉन इकोनॉमिक एक्टिविटीज कैनॉट बी मेजर्ड इन टर्म्स ऑफ मनी, Then one example you can give regarding economic activities and non-economic activities. For example, if teacher is teaching in a school, means he is providing services to school, against that whatever income he is earning, that is called economic activity. And if the same teacher is teaching his own son, own daughter, own wards at home, then such activities is considered as non-economic activities, because when he is teaching his own son, own daughter, means he is providing services out of love or affection towards their children, and such activities cannot be measured in terms of money. That's why it is called non-economic activity or activities. So second topic, economic activities and non-economic activities, is completed on page number 3. Now page number 4. Topic is microeconomics and macroeconomics. Microeconomics and macroeconomics.
Now, before explaining microeconomics and macroeconomics, that is given on page number 4, try to understand point number 1.6, presentation of information in economics. Then after that, page number 5, page number 6, page number 7, page number 8 and 9, you are not required to do. Reason, presentation of information in economics, importance of statistical information, which is given on page number 5, you have already done in state. Regarding importance, means for example, importance of statistics, characteristics of statistics, such theory portion you have already done in state in 11th standard. Then page number 6, 1.9, page number 6, different types of diagrams or graphs you have to study in 12th standard in economics. And last, importance of economics you have already done in states also, or you have to do in 12th standard also. So last topic is, according to this chapter, microeconomics and macroeconomics. After this topic, you are not required to do anything from this chapter. So after completion of this topic, this chapter is completed. Once again, try to understand. Page number 1 you have to do. And on page number 1, only meaning of economics. Topic is meaning of economics. Then page number 2, topic is development of economics as a science in the West. From this topic, only you have to learn the name of economics, published books by them, and the year in which they had published the book. Means total 4 names are given: Adam Smith, Alfred Marshall, Lionel Robbins, and Paul Samuelson. Paul Samuelson is given on page number 3. Then next topic, economic activity and non-economic activity. What is economic activity? What is non-economic activity? Or what is the difference between economic activities and non-economic activities? At least 3 to 4 points you have to learn. Or whatever theory you have learned in OC, same answer you can write in economics also. And last topic, microeconomics and macroeconomics, which is given on page number 4, 1.5. And after this, no topic is required to learn or do for exam purpose. Because after this, whatever topic is given, that is you have already done in statistics in 11th standard, or some topic here you have to do in 12th standard. Now, what is microeconomics and macroeconomics? Micro means small, and macro means large. Micro means small, macro means large. Now, micro means, microeconomics means when we are studying, economic theory when we are studying economic theory on individual basis, or we are studying economic theory of individual unit, then it is called microeconomics. When we are studying economic theory of individual unit in the economy, is called microeconomics. Now, what is the meaning of individual unit here? For example, if we want to know the demand of, demand means, once again, we have already done chapter number 3, डिमांड इज ऑलवेज फ्रॉम द साइड ऑफ कंज्यूमर्स, गुड्स आर डिमांडेड बाय द कंज्यूमर्स. सो इफ यू वॉन्ट टू नो द डिमांड ऑफ शूज, डिमांड ऑफ शूज ऑफ डिफरेंट कंपनीज, देर आर वेरियस कंपनीज हु आर प्रोड्यूसिंग शूज, वॉट इज द डिमांड ऑफ शूज ऑफ डिफरेंट कंपनीज बाय कंज्यूमर्स. इट मीन्स हेयर वी आर स्टडिंग अबाउट द डिमांड बट ओनली ऑफ वन पर्टिकुलर कमोडिटी, दैट इज शूज. दैट इज द अदर थिंग दैट वी आर स्टडिंग अबाउट द डिमांड ऑफ शूज ऑफ ऑल कंपनीज हु आर प्रोड्यूसिंग शूज. डिफरेंट कंपनीज मीन्स ऑल कंपनीज इन इंडिया हु आर प्रोड्यूसिंग शूज, वॉट इज द डिमांड ऑफ द शूज प्रोड्यूस्ड बाई देम बाई द कंज्यूमर्स, वी आर ट्राइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट दैट. बट हेयर वी आर स्टडिंग अबाउट द डिमांड ऑफ ओनली वन कमोडिटी, वन प्रोडक्ट, दैट इज शूज. दैट्स वाई हेयर वी आर स्टडिंग अबाउट द डिमांड ऑफ ओनली वन प्रोडक्ट. इट मीन्स वी आर स्टडिंग अबाउट अ स्मॉल टॉपिक इन केस ऑफ डिमांड. That's why it is called microeconomics. Here we are studying about demand of not of all products produced in India. We are discussing about the demand of only one product which is produced by different companies in India, and demand we are talking about demand by consumers. So here we are talking about or we are discussing about only one topic, one demand of one product. That's why it is called microeconomics. But when we will study about the demand of all products, each and every products, when we talk about demand of each and every products produced in India in the current year, then it becomes macroeconomics. Here we are discussing about the demand of the whole product produced in India in the current year. That's why here this is called microeconomics. So whenever we are studying a part of economic theory, or we can say we are studying about an individual unit. Another example we can take, if we want to know percentage of employment, this is the another example regarding microeconomics. When we want to know percentage of employment, only in agricultural sector. Now here we are not trying to know the percentage of employment in all sector. Here we are studying about the percentage of employment, means whatever total working population means those who want to work or those who are doing work, that is called working population. So out of total working population, what is the percentage of individuals who are engaged in agricultural sector? Means here we are trying to calculate, we are trying to understand the percentage of employment only and only in agricultural sector. Means we are talking about one unit. Then it is called microeconomics. Now when it becomes macroeconomics, when we try to know percentage of employment in all sectors, agricultural sector, industrial sector, service sector, then it becomes macroeconomics, because here we are trying to calculate percentage of employment in all sector, means economy as a whole. So whenever we are studying economic theory, definition of microeconomics, now try to bring difference between micro and macro. The first difference is, so when we are studying economic theory of an individual unit, either it is demand
or its supply or employment or incomes. For example, if we try to calculate income, only income of only and only agricultural sector or industrial sector, any one sector, then it is called microeconomics. But when we are calculating the total income earned by these all these three sectors, then it becomes national income and it is called macroeconomics. So whenever we are studying definition of microeconomics, so through these points we try to bring difference between micro and macro. Macroeconomics. First point, study of economic theory of an individual unit. Study of economic theory of an individual unit is called microeconomics. And when we are studying study of economic theory of aggregation, one word, aggregation. Aggregation means total. Aggregation of economy as a whole. Economy as a whole is called macroeconomics. Study of economic theory of aggregation means here, for example, if we are trying to know the demand of particular product in the given year by the consumer, then it is called microeconomics. But when we are trying to know the demand of all products, total of all products, total means aggregation, sum, S-U-M, sum, addition. Study of economic theory of addition of economy as a whole means here, whatever topic we are trying to understand, that topic, that matter, we are trying to calculate on the whole basis, total basis. If we are trying to know the demand, so we are trying to know the total demand of total products. If you are trying to know the supply, so we are trying to know the supply of all products. If you are trying to know the income, so here we are trying to know the income of individual earned by in all sectors, agricultural sector, industrial sector and service sector. But here we are trying to understand or trying to know the income of a particular industry, either it is a particular sector, either it is industrial sector or I mean we are trying to study any matter on individual basis, then it becomes micro. Second point, what type of things we are studying in microeconomics? Demand, supply. You have already studied different chapters. Demand chapter you have done, supply chapter you have done, then cost and revenue, income of an individual unit. Such type of things we try to study in microeconomics. Here demand means we are trying to know the demand of any particular commodity. We are trying to know the supply of any particular commodity, not all. But when we are trying to know the demand of all commodities produced in the economy, then it is called aggregate demand. Means in case of macroeconomics, we try to understand about aggregate demand. Or aggregate supply. Here national income, we try to know about national income, not income of a particular sector. Here we are trying to know the national income of the whole economy. These are the examples of etc. These are the examples of macroeconomics. When we are studying economic theory about national income, means here we are trying to understand national income is income of the whole economy. But in case of microeconomics, we are trying to understand or trying to know the income of a particular individual unit. For example, income of agricultural sector or income of industrial sector, when we are studying a particular unit, income of particular unit, then it is the study of microeconomics. Any other difference? Yes, micro means small. Micro means small. Macro means large. Any other difference? Microeconomics is also known as price theory. It is also known as price theory. Now, why it is called price theory? Whenever I have already told you how one question we have already done in demand or supply chapter, how equilibrium price is determined. How equilibrium price is determined. So price of any commodity is determined on the basis of their demand and supply. One question we have done, the demand is sloping downward. This question we have done in supply chapter, and supply curve is sloping upward. So wherever demand curve and supply curve intersect each other, at that point, whatever price is given, that price is decided in the market for that particular product. That's why on the basis of demand and supply, price is decided. So the objective of microeconomics is to decide price. That's why it is called price theory also. And macroeconomics, it is also known as income and employment theory. Income and employment theory. Because after studying aggregate demand, aggregate supply, national income, we are trying to know about the total income earned by the nation or total working population engaged in different sectors. That's why macroeconomics is also known as income and employment theory, whereas microeconomics is known as price theory. So this is the difference between microeconomics and macroeconomics, and this way chapter is completed.